Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna. Gurur Brahma, Gurur Vishnu, Gurur Devo Maheshwaraha, Guru Sakshat Param Brahma, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. I have heard so many things about me which I never knew. In all this, it was more of the erudition and scholarship and literary touch that this girl has given. See? About Swamis and Mahatmas, never things are spoken like that. He is a Swami, is more than enough. Are we marketing somebody or what? See, friends, next time never do that to anybody. See? It is contrary to the very tradition of our culture. We don't have to say all these things. Anyway, we can't undo it. We all have studied Bhagavad Gita and you particularly are all expert. I am afraid of speaking in front of you, yet I will try my best. All that is said in Bhagavad Gita, Karma Yoga, Ashtanga Yoga, Bhakti Yoga, Jnana Yoga, none of that was ever practiced by Arjun. Am I right? Where was this knowledge given? This knowledge was given on the battlefield. There were two armies standing, and in the no man's land, Bhagavad Gita was declared. Was there any time for Arjun to sit and do meditation? Shucho deshe pratishthapya sthiramasanam atmanaha natyuchritam natinijam jay chainajara kushottaram. No, he didn't do all that. Nor did he take mai eva manadasva mai buddhim niveshaya nivasishyasya mai eva ata urdhvam na samshaya. He did not try upasana. See? He did not do karma yoga. Mai sarvani karmani sanyasya dhyatma chetasa nirashi dhirma mubhutva yudhyasva vigatajvara. He didn't try that. Vidya vire sampanne brahmane gavihastiri shuri chaiva shvapa kecha panditaha samadarshinaha. He did not practice path of knowledge. Oh God, what did he do? See. Therefore, we all have to understand one thing technically called as the Tatparya Niranay, and in our simple language it is called as moral of the story. And this moral of the story, if we understand properly, then you will see spiritual life is a fun, is a joy. It's not a burden. Many places we come across people walking spiritual path, they are as if carrying a cross to be crucified after some time. This spiritual life is not a burden, it's a fun, the joy, provided we understand. See, it is something like this. One or two examples will make clear. There was a small girl, now she is a grown-up, she must be 25 years or so. She was maybe like this girl, even smaller than her. She used to call me my Swami. And any other child coming near me, she will go and hit that, get away from my Swami. Nobody could touch me. I was her possession. So once I went to her house and mother, father, that small child and me. After some time I said, hey, look here, You have got both, mom and dad. I don't have anybody. Why not we share? So I'll take your daddy, father, and you keep the mother. So when I held that baby, that father of her, then pulled him, I said, hey, let's go to my house. She started crying, holding on to the father, don't take my dad, please. I said, okay, keep dad, I'll take mom. Then I held the mother and was carrying her with me. Again she said, no, no, don't take. I said, this is not good. One of the two you have to give me. With her small little hands, like a frog's hand, she was holding both the parents and crying, no, you cannot, you should not. I said, I have to take. May what happened? She became so miserable, crying, crying, crying. When this was happening, was I suffering? Was her mother suffering? Was her father suffering? We all were having fun, is it not? Because we know we are not going to do that. But the child didn't know. Exactly the same way. Come to Bhagavad Gita. Arjun tells Bhagavan Sri Krishna. Senayor Ubhayor Madhe Ratham Sthapaya Mechuta. Hey Achyuta, hey Lord, take my chariot between the two armies. For what? I want to check. Who are those who dare fight with me? See the arrogance a person has. And then, those with whom I have to fight, they are very bad people. Durbuddhi. When these two things happen in our life, Bhagwan starts playing his Krishna Leela. So what Bhagwan did? He took the chariot according to the order of the boss. But where? He had a choice. Just imagine for the sake of understanding, if the chariot was taken and placed in front of Duryodhan or Dushasan, will Arjun ever ask any question whether I should fight or not? But what Bhagavan did? Senayor Ubhayor Madhe Bhishma Drona Pramukataha Sarvesham Cha Mahikshitam. So many warriors were there, leaving everybody aside in front of Bhishmacharya Dronacharya. And not only that, he kept. He gave a chabi, like I was playing with the child. I want to take your mom, I want to take your dad. Bhagavan said, you don't have to fight with the enemies. You have to fight with your grandfather and you have to fight with your guru. And when Arjuna started crying, Katam Bhishma Maham Sanghe Dronam Chodasudana, Bhagavan was smiling. Like I was smiling when the girl was crying, don't take my mom and dad. As it was a fun for me with that girl. Lord has a fun with us when we cry. And he creates the situation. See? Because he knows the result. Bhagavan knew the result. Like we go to the hospitals, emergency ward. The persons who are accompanying the patient, they do not know the emergency status of that particular case. But all the doctors and nurses there, they know, because every patient is emergency there. They know what is the status of emergency. Therefore, they are cool. But we get so excited. Oh, these doctors are very irresponsible. They don't take care of my... But they are cool. They are not excited. See, friends. Bhagavan says, Gatasu na gatasuscha nanu shochanti panditaha. When Arjuna was crying, frustrated, that time Bhagavan gives him one very hard. Ashochanano shochastvam prajnavadamscha bhashase gatasu na gatasuscha nanu shochanti panditaha. See, wise people are those who don't cry, who are not miserable, who are not grieving for every small little thing. See? And ignorant people cry and become miserable. For what? For two reasons. Because somebody died, they are miserable. Because somebody doesn't die, that also makes them miserable. Ye marta bhi nahi. See, friends. Therefore, one principle we have to understand, moral of the story. Every event that is happening in our life must remind us of the divine. If we remember the Lord, we cannot be miserable. Forgetting the Lord is equal to being miserable. If you think of Lord, and what is Bhagwan? Bhagwan is Ananda. So when you think of Ananda, how can you be miserable? See, friends. Therefore, like Kabirji Maharaj says, Dukh mein sumiran sab kare, sukh mein kare na koi. If we start keeping ourselves in tune with the divine plan, you see, life is a great fun. And it is for this purpose that we have to rethink about our way of looking at life. It is for this purpose every statement in the scripture is meant. See, every scripture statement has got three meanings. One is adhi bhautik meaning, second is adhi daivik meaning, and the third is adhyatmik meaning. Adhi bhautik meaning means when we take this world as real, how should we live in this world? We can't live the way we want. No. See? We have a freedom to drive the car on the road. But that freedom is guarded freedom. We cannot drive the way we want. We have to follow certain rules and regulations. As long as we drive the car. Once in Delhi, my friend, she was driving. So I told her, I said, Mama, this is a red light. You are in Delhi and you are afraid of red light? She got inspired and she crossed the red light and police caught. Life is a fun, don't make it seriously. So, when the police stopped, he became very angry and he said, "Didn't you see the red light?" So, on her behalf, I told, "Yes, I saw the red light." "Then why did she drive the car?" I said, "We didn't see you." "Have we seen you?" Stop. He said, "Anyway, you have to pay the fine." I said, "Okay, I'll pay the fine. It is my fault. I told her to drive fast. Tell me, how much I have to pay?" And he said, "You don't know anything." I said, "What?" "Traffic rules are applied on the driver, not on the passenger." See, can there be a higher wisdom than this? Till such time, we consider this world as real. And I want to do something. Till such time, there is I, the doer. I am doing this, I am doing that. Nothing wrong. Follow the rules. And if whatever is done is his will, no rules apply. Ahankara vimudhatma karta ahamiti manyate. Whenever we are miserable, we are caught on the wrong footings because we have this notion, I am doing. We can't do anything in this world. You must have seen sometime. In a very important meeting, you are all sitting in a round table with a cup of tea or coffee, very serious matter. And one of us, they says, excuse me. So everybody is ready to receive the sneeze with a Purna Kumbha. He is ready. And it doesn't come. what is under our control? See, friends. There are people who want to become fat Therefore, they eat the buffalo live. Yet they continue to be agarbatti. The other extreme, they want to reduce the weight, the fattiness. They look at the ice cream and they put on 5 kilograms. What control we have? But ahankara vimudhatma karta amiti vanyate. See friends, to remove these wrong notions from our life, Lord creates these kinds of situations wherein we are asked to rethink. See. And when there are problems which we cannot sort out all by ourselves, then we go to the temple. And after going to the temple, what is our prayer to the Lord? O Lord, you are the means and the success of my life is the goal. What should be the thing? My life is the means and you are the goal of my life. But we change. The goal is made as the means and the means are converted into goal. Don't we do this? Saturday, Hanumanji, Sri Guru Charan Sarvara Jarado, my exams are coming. O Lord, let's see that I am through the examination, although I have not studied. I know. In one place, in India, there was a teacher with whom I was staying and she was examining her papers. And one paper she showed me, Swamiji, what will you do to this answer book? So, whatever was the subject, the whole answer book was only Sri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram, Sri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram, Sri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram, Sri Ram, Jai Jai Ram. The whole answer book was filled with Ram Naam Japa and said, for God's sake, please pass me. So she asked me, Swamiji, tell me what I should do. I said, fail that fellow. See, friends, our devotion is not devotion. Because the very purpose of our life is get lost in this world. See, friends, remember, every difficulty in our life is a God-sent blessing. Because of which we may think changing the direction of our life from the dog world to the God world. Presently we are going dogwards. See? Early morning, these ammas get up with their nightie, not even taking bath or having anything, simply take that doggy with the lead and go out. For what? Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam. Unless that doggy goes to his own pillar, he will not do. So our life is guided by the dogs, not by the God. See, my friends, therefore, every difficulty in our life will give us an opportunity. Let us change the direction of life. Had this situation been not created by the Lord, what was the situation created by Lord? Very clearly he told, you have to fight with your guru and with your grandfather. We all have this problem. Dealing and fighting with the enemies is not a big issue. But when our own nears and dears, when they stand against us as our enemies, then comes a real challenge in life. See, friends. And what is the challenge? Challenge is only mamata. See. Mamata is about something other than the body. With reference to body, there are two bindings. Mamata and ahanta. So unless we are able to withdraw from the world, we will not be able to transcend the ahanta, the ahankar. And therefore, the Lord starts playing games with us. Once, in some place, after my talk was over, one elderly Swami, Gambhirananda, all the time very serious, he told me, that time I was young, देखो बेटा, यू शुड नॉट टॉक सो लाइटली ऑन गीता. आई सेड ओके सर, आई विल नॉट टॉक, आई विल टॉक हेविली. एंड देन वन कमंडलू वॉज देयर. कमंडलू आज स्वामी जी, वाई डिंट यू टेल हिम? आई सेड लुक हियर, देर आर सर्टन रूल्स इन धर्मशास्त्र अबाउट एल्डर्स. यू शुड नेवर आर्ग्यू वॉट एवर द एल्डर्स से बिफोर हियरिंग से यस. Never argue or discuss anything with the elderly people. Because when you say yes immediately, without even listening, they forget about what yes. Then you relax. And if you start argument, discussion, it goes into their head and they trouble us. I said that is a simple technique. So the best way to disagree with anybody is to agree immediately. Okay. He said, no, but you tell me. I said, look here. If you study original Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavad Gita was never told by Bhagavan Krishna with the hanky in the hand and tears in the eyes. No. Prasanniva Bharata. When the original Bhagavad Gita was delivered happily, cheerfully, why we should make it miserable? See? We are going contrary to his principle. Therefore, the Dharma Shastra tells us, take every issue of your life according to rules and regulations. Follow that. Then what will happen? You will have no problem. Whatever you have to do, you are done. That's it. Because all the karma, bhakti, whatever said in Bhagavad Gita, Arjuna has not done anything. Then what happened actually? See, friends, there are few things which happen. First thing, that what happened to Dhritarashtra who heard Bhagavad Gita, what happened to Sanjay who heard Bhagavad Gita, what happened to Arjuna who heard Bhagavad Gita, and what happened to us when you are listening from me? Four of them. Like in Ramcharitmanas, the description is there are four ghats of the Manas Sarovar. On one ghat, it is Lord Shiva and Parvati, Jnana Ghat. Other, it is Bharadwaja and the third one, it is Kakbhushundi. And fourth is Tulsidaji and the devotees. Four of them. Similarly, Bhagavad Gita also has these four Ghat. On one, Bhagavan Krishna talking to Arjuna. On second, Bhagavan Krishna talking and Sanjay is hearing. Third, Sanjay is talking and Dhritarashtra is hearing. And fourth, I am talking. Who is hearing? Okay. Now, after Bhagavad Gita was heard by Dhritarashtra from Sanjay, what happened to Dhritarashtra? Nowhere it is mentioned in the whole Bhagavad Gita, in the whole Mahabharata. Nothing happened to him. If somebody is sleeping, you can wake him up. If somebody is pretending, you can't wake him up. Exactly the same way, we fall in the category of Dhritarashtra. Nothing happened to us because essentially we are asangoham, asangoham, asangoham punah punah. So many Mahatmas have come, so many satsang we have heard, nothing can touch us. We belong to Dhritarashtra category. What are Dhritarashtra's category? He refused to change his standpoint. Friends, real spiritual practice begins when we understand the secret of standpoints in life. What are the possible standpoints? First, we'll take through some example. First standpoint, waves against waves. Second standpoint, waves against the ocean. Third standpoint, ocean against the waves. four standpoint, water against the ocean and the waves. So many relations. Now apply this. I versus you. Wave against wave. Second, I versus Lord. Wave against ocean. Lord looking at us. Ocean looking at the waves. And fourth, Paramatma looking at the Lord and the world. Water looking at the ocean and the waves. What will be the experience? I against you will be nothing but fighting, competition, jealousy, trying to prove holier than thou. Do you know? I wake up early in the morning and I don't eat every day non-vegetarian, only alternatives. Superior than thou, you know. And I don't drink in the temple. This holier than thou will happen when the relationship is between I versus you. See, such holy crooks are big problem for themselves. See, friends. Then the second verse is I versus the Lord. We don't compete with our Lord. Oh Lord, majay tumare. You are enjoying and we are suffering here. No, we don't compete. Then we surrender. Second standpoint of life. So when we are engaged in karma, we have that strong I. And such people, you see, in this world, those who are working hard, doing very sincerely good to everybody, at the end of their life, they are totally frustrated. The reason is only this. Because that their I was very strong. For example, I'll tell you, there is one lady, maybe mid-40s or so, and she happened to talk to me somewhere. After my evening dinner, I went for a walk. She said, Swamiji, I want to come with you. I said, no, I can go alone and come back. No, but I want to go with you. I said, okay, but don't sit on my head, okay? She'll fall. So, she came. Swamiji, I want to ask something personal. I said, I have nothing personal. My life is a public life. No personal. No, I want to tell my personal. I said, I am not interested in your personal. Why should I know what you have got? Keep your garbage with you? No, but I want to tell. I said, anyway, I can't run away. Go ahead. As you listen to my satsang, I listen to you. Then she told, Swamiji, when I was hardly 20, I had two younger sisters, one brother. That time our father died. And there was no support. So I had to work hard, I had to study, and I had to look after my sisters and my brother. I got them educated, I got them married, I got them settled in life. And now I am mid-40s, and when I go to their place, they tell in clear terms, Didi, please don't come to our house, our spouse do not like it. If you want to meet us, give us a call. We'll meet in some restaurant. And after that, Ganga, Yamuna and Saraswati. Swamiji, tell why this is happening. Why nobody wants me? Why everybody is avoiding me? I told in my mind, I wish I can also go away. We become like the mosquito repellents. We become human repellent. It's only because of the strong I. See, like wherever there is a strong magnetic circle, there the things are immediately influenced. Exactly. Our this ego is so strong, people don't like us. See, instead of the divine expressing, the devil expresses. If you are at peace with yourself, We don't have to prove anything to anybody in this world. Just be yourself. That's it. There is no competition. See, friends. Recently, I was in England, and that open ground where cricket matches happened, there was a big function. Not a function, a program. Body, mind, and soul function was there. So they had asked me to come for a talk, and the time they had given was not suitable because that time I was in India. I said, sorry, I cannot come that time. So I said, anyway, I'll see the fun around. So I was moving various stalls, the yoga accessories. See, if you take this rope and hang yourself, you have to do no yoga afterwards. Yoga accessories. Horrible thing. But there are, you know, dumb people buying that. So I was moving around and enjoying, having coffee and all that. And one stall we went, and that lady was standing there. My friend said, Swamiji, here they see the aura and they judge and they give you energy. I say, would you like to do that? I said, look here, I am with you. Whatever you do with me, I have no problem. Do whatever you like. Swamiji, let us try this. I said, okay, is it free or payment? Free. I said, then anything is okay. I believe in free. Because I believe in freedom. So we went there. And she told, I'll take only 5 minutes. She put the alarm 5 minutes and took something in her hand and she asked, you sit down here. I said, what I have to do? You have to do nothing. Relax. I said, okay, I'm always relaxed. So I sat down and watching the people and all that. And she was with all seriousness standing on her two legs and eyes closed and doing something. I don't know, bluff or real. How do you know? After 5 minutes, the alarm went. Then she came down to my feet. You are terrible. I said, what did I do? Instead of me giving you energy, you have pushed me by your energy. What did you do? I said, I did nothing. See, friends, don't have that strong personality. See? Now, what was happening with her? Wrong understanding. Her understanding was, I have done so much for them. Remember basic principle. Whatever we do in our life, nobody needs it. It is our need that we do whatever we do. Do you think Bhagwan needs aarti? You and me need it. Do you think Bhagwan needs Naivedyam? Is he hungry? Think, friends. Once this basic principle error is corrected, that ego, that arrogance, I have done this thing, I have done that thing, will disappear. And when the ego disappears, Paramatma expresses. In disappearance of the devil, the divine expresses. Then the expression of the divine is only happiness, not misery. Bhagavan did not create this world out of misery. Oh God, I have to produce the world. No. Cheerfully, happily. Ananda deva kalvimani bhutani jayante. Anandena jatani jivante. See. When the ocean is happy, happiness of the ocean is waves. See, friends. Therefore, what is the moral of the story? What Arjuna did not understand? He thought he is fighting this war. He doesn't know whether I should kill them or they should kill me, as if there is a possible option or what. Therefore, one basic thing in karma we should understand, whatever we are doing, nobody needs it. It is our need. The day we take this as the moral of the story, whatever we are doing, nobody needs it, it is our need. And when it is our need, we cannot be arrogant. We will be with all humility. See? And this you all must have experienced. When you go through immigration in any country, in front of the immigration officer, we are all at our best. Why? It is our need to enter the country. They don't want us. Once it happened probably in Australia or New Zealand, we were going, big crowd, I think 3-4 flights came simultaneously. And one of the passengers, when he was going through immigration, in front of one immigration officer, there was some kind of argument, logic, and shouting and fighting. The security came and bundled him up and took him away, and the whole atmosphere became very tense. Oh God, what is happening? And I had a friend with me, and he was holding my hand. He said, Swamiji, pray to the Lord, we should not go to the same immigration officer. We should go to someone else. I said, look here, relax, man, relax. No, nothing will happen. No, no, you don't know. He's already angry, and he will take their anger on us. Let us pray we should not go to him. I said, you pray, I don't pray. And it so happened, we were directed towards that only. And he was holding my hand raised so tightly that my blood circulation stopped. I said, forget about it. And we went, I gave my passport, he just took it and put the stamp and go. Not one question asked. I am relieved. I said, you are relieved of that problem which did not exist. We all try to solve those problems which never exist. That struggle to solve the non-existing problems is called as worry. I don't know what is going to happen to this world. If you don't know, enjoy. If you know, be prepared. Where is the place for worrying, worrying, worrying? And to get out of this worry is the second path. The second path is simply bhajan kirtan, nothing will help you. Jehi vidhi rakhe Ram, tehi vidhi rahiye. Saying is different and living 24/7 is different. See, my friends, therefore, when we surrender ourselves at the feet of the Lord, be very attentive. What happens? Moral of the story. You bypass the law of karma. Law of karma is for whom? The traffic rules are applied for whom? Those who are driving the car. Not the one who is sitting in a passenger seat. Exactly the same way. When we surrender ourselves to the Lord, we are no more the driver. And when we are not the driver, law of karma is not applicable to us. One taxi driver takes the passenger to a temple. He will not get the merit. He will get his meter reading. From the temple, the next passenger, he gets to go to the drinking booth. From solid spirituality to liquid spirituality. So when he takes the second passenger to the drinking booth, he doesn't get the sin. He gets his only meter reading. Exactly the same way. Yad yad karma karo mitatta dakilam shambho tavaradhana. When this attitude changes, in changing the attitude is the only way to bypass the law of karma. On a devotee, law of karma is not applicable. For the devotee, there is no punarapi jananam, punarapi maranam, punarapi janani jatare shayanam. For the devotee, there is no hell and heaven. For the devotee, only Paramatma. Be attentive. Paramatma being one. If you hold on to the one, the mind dissolves in consciousness. When the mind holds on to something which is more than one, mind starts spinning. And if the theme is the world, the mind will gather a momentum. And in that momentum, we get carried away and suffer. Such people, they call themselves as sentimental. They just can't keep quiet. Watch within yourself how much you talk to yourself. And what we talk to ourselves? Only about the future. I had to go there, I will do this thing, so many people are coming, I said, but there is no electricity, what will I do? Unnecessarily relax. If everything we do, what will he do? He will become unemployed. And you will see, unemployed people are problematic. So keep him busy. Surrender at his feet. And let him do the job. And you, Moj Miro, relax. See, friends. So, the karma yoga or karma is told that we should become disciplined and responsible for our life. But when we become disciplined and responsible, then our I becomes very strong. And such people, they do a lot for everybody. And yet, in the heart of their heart, they are most miserable. Look at the old parents. Why the old parents are miserable? Because the basics are not clear. Fundamentals are not clear, then the life is mental. When the fundamentals are clear, life is fun. That is why the word fundamental. So either fun or mental, two extremes. See, friends. Therefore, we have to very clearly understand that whatever karma we are doing, we are in need, nobody needs us. So there won't be any arrogance of doership. And to get out of that arrogance of doership, the next step is told in Bhagavad Gita that you have to practice this upasana. Now here there is another important thing we have to understand. Devotion and upasana, they are different. Upasana is outside. We are sitting here in this holy place. All our gods are in front of us. We are chanting the Lord's name. We are doing bhajan kirtan. We are doing the japa. We are doing the aarti. This is upasana. It is outside. Devotion happens inside. Upasana is done. Devotion happens. And this can happen only when we do this upasana. Upasana means what? Upam is near, asana means go near to the Lord. So whenever we are engaging ourselves in the karma, there is always a possibility that our I may become very strong and therefore we are initiated into the path of upasana. And this path of upasana, if it does not go properly, it remains only at the periphery. About this, I'll tell you one beautiful thing, a story you can call it. The purpose of upasana is what? Moral of the story. There is one text called as Tripura Rahasya. You might have heard the name. It is one of the most difficult and the most enchanting text. And the story goes like this. Parshuramji has killed Kshatriyas 21 times. And he was extremely angry, frustrated with the Kshatriyas. 22nd time, he has to deal with Bhagwan Ram. And there he was defeated. Parshuramji was defeated. So when he got defeated, he went to the forest, to the mountains. So all the frustrated people become Babaji. They go to Himalayas. Because they could not continue in the world, so they become Babaji. Parshuramji also went there. And there he came across a real Mahatma, not the fake. We are the tailor-made Mahatmas, you know. In one of my friend who is a good tailor, there is a some slip written in his shop. God created man, we create a gentleman. Very true. Without the drive, with the tailor, we can't be gentlemen. So he went there and he came across a Mahatma, and in his very presence, Parashuramji dissolved all his agitations, everything, and he experienced something which was never experienced by him. This experience. Thereafter, he asked, "Sir, what is this experience? I never had this." He said, "This is Brahmananda." "What Brahmananda? Please explain me properly. Simply telling doesn't mean anything. You have to explain me. What is Brahmananda?" That Mahatma knew. He is a gone case. He is an intellectual. Intellectuals can never be happy in life. Intellectuals are intelligently miserable. They prove under all these conditions anybody will be miserable, and that is me. Logically, you can never be happy. See, friends. So he said, "Look here, you are very intelligent. I cannot teach you because I am illiterate. Chora Ganga Kinare Wala. I can't tell you anything. You go to an intelligent guru, and that is Bhagwan Dattatreya." And he goes to Bhagwan Dattatreya. And Dattatreya ji immediately recognizes the case. Looking at the very face, he knew what is the problem. And Parashuramji says, "So this is what happened, but he was not able to tell me properly, therefore I have come to you." "Yes, you are right perfectly. How just can anybody know what is Brahmananda? You have to do sadhana. You have to do upasana." "Yes, this guru knows something, you know." So he took one stone. This is Tripura Devi. And 101 rules and regulations were told. Keep on such and such asana and give bath in this thing, that thing, and this naivedya, this puja, this agarbatti, and this aarti, and you do pradakshina, and you should sleep on the floor, you should not take proper food, you should take cold water bath, give hot water bath to the goddess, you take cold water bath, and you starve, but give a nice naivedya to the goddess, and you have to do it for 12 years. Inspired, and went to the forest and took that stone, came Devi Mata, and started. 1 day, 2 days, 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, 10 years, 12 years. And after 12 years, he said, "Come on, what I have been doing? I only tell the stories, the goddess. She never said anything. I think I have wasted my 12 years of life." He went back to Guru. "Guru Maharaj, I think I have wasted 12 years of my life. Who is this Tripura Devi you are talking about?" Then Bhagavan Dattatreya tells, "Look here, you have not wasted. Be very attentive. The principle of upasana is jidnyasa. If your upasana is mature enough, you will get the inquiry kindled in your heart. Who am I? What is God? What is the world? What is spiritual practice?" Like when a fruit becomes mature on the tree, it becomes ripened on the tree, it detaches from the tree without efforts. Exactly the same way, when upasana becomes mature, fulfilled, it ends up in inquiry. Kastvam koham kutamayataha kame janani को मे दातः इति परिभावय सर्वं असारं विश्वं त्यक्त्वा स्वप्न विचारं भज गोविंदम भज गोविंदम. That is the purpose of upasana. And when this upasana becomes mature enough, the maturity of the upasana is discovery of devotion within. And where there is a devotion in the heart, there cannot be fear, there cannot be desire, there cannot be ahankar. See? Because now the Lord has manifested in the heart. Manifestation of the Lord in the heart is called as devotion. Like manifestation of electricity in the bulb is called as light. When God expresses through our heart, that expression is called as devotion. Where there is light, there cannot be darkness. Where there is devotion, there cannot be fear. Where there is a devotion, there cannot be desire. Where there is devotion, there cannot be bitterness. Where there is devotion, there cannot be any demand. See, friends. Therefore, karma is done karmani chitta shuddhyartham. Karma is not done to prove something to somebody in this world. But what we become miserable in life is because of this basic principle we are not learned. The principle is very simple. Whenever we are doing something and becoming happy or miserable, what is the cause? Find out. So we'll come to know. We are at the same time parents as well as children. We are children to our parents. And we are parents to our children. So we are two in one. Are we miserable because of our parents? Do we opt for a choice? I wish my mother was, let us say, Marilyn Monroe. How nice it would have been. No. We give ourselves zero choice as regards the parents are concerned. We don't choose parents. Therefore, when we don't choose parents, we are happy with them. But when it comes to children, there we don't understand. We do not choose children. See, friends. What we give to the children is only the body. Like we have some property which we rent it out to the tenants. Now the tenant who is coming in that property, you can't dictate on him or her. No, 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 you should not eat non-vegetarian. You should do meditation. No, he will do whatever he likes. See, friends. So if this basic principle we understand, as we have no choice with reference to our parents, equally we have no choice with reference to our children. Therefore, what will happen? Don't expect anything from them. But instead of that, constantly complain. Wherever I go, these parents have no business. All the time, Swamiji, my children, what should I do? I said, look here, I didn't tell you to produce children. Now you suffer. Don't make you suffer. And they go for a Swamiji, why don't you start some school? I said, I don't want to do anything. But why all the Mahatmas do? I said, then you go to them. I am not going to do anything. But why you don't want to start the school? I said, you want to know the reason? You produce children and I run school. Am I mad or what? See, friends, remember this principle. Then that is called as real devotion happening in our heart. But instead of that, Swamiji, when we were at home, our parents used to be there and we used to be obedient to the parents. We used to listen to them. We used to respect them. But these days, children, they don't listen to us, they don't respect us. So what is the reason? So I said, look here, reason is very simple. We were lucky to have good parents. Our children are unfortunate. They have got dumb parents and therefore they can't listen to us. Get out of this complaint mode. A devotee never complains. See, life becomes very simple. And to practice this, we have to be disciplined. And the discipline is inculcated through yoga abhyas. Normally by yoga we mean twisting the body. No, straightening the mind. Not twisting the body. Whatever you may do, every body has its path clearly indicated. When the constructions are made, let us say a bridge, that time they tell that this bridge is meant to be viable, workable for 100 years. Exactly the same way, every body that is born, what will be the experiences the body has go through, what will be the longevity of that body, and what will be the shape of that body is predetermined. Nobody can change it. In front of Bhagwan Sri Krishna, Abhimanyu was killed on the battlefield. Couldn't he stop that? See, friends, but for us, yoga means only the body, body, body. Enough, it is required, no doubt. But we have to work through the body, not work as the body. And for that purpose, yoga is told. So, three things. What is the purpose? What is the moral of the story? Karma is done so that we are able to achieve success and don't lead a disgusting life. Work hard. That is our responsibility for that Dharma Shastra. Then second thing is, when we do that, we become very successful and arrogant. Konyoti sadrusho maya. I have done that. To get out of it, we are told upasana. When we do this upasana, in that upasana is outside, devotion happens inside. And if the devotion has happened, we are always at peace with ourselves as well as with the world. It is for this purpose all the things are told in the scriptures. And the most important thing, what happened to Arjuna? We are all here for a purpose, and that purpose is determined by the Lord, not by us. This is another principle we have to understand. This mic has no purpose. The one who is using the mic, he has a purpose. Mic can remain in the box, no problem. And if I have to use this mic, what I expect? Mic should not produce its own sound. Only my voice should go to you. But sometimes you must have seen, these mics have their own personality. Sometimes they will be doing the electronic omkar. Om. Immediately we turn on. Sometimes the mic keeps on clearing its own throat. Khar, 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 khar. And if the mic will not listen, we throw him away. Exactly the same way. For remaining between the speaker and the audience, mic must be a perfect instrument. Exactly the same way. For remaining between the Lord and His creation, we have to be a perfect instrument. If I have to do something, I will search for a right person. See? Exactly the same way. If the Lord wants to do something in this world, He is in search of a right person. So what is our sadhana? Remain as a perfect instrument, so that he will choose us. So all our sadhana is only this, remain as a perfect instrument. And what is a perfect instrument? Like the mic, which does not make its own noise. And what is our noise? I. iPhone, iPad. I use Samsung. You must have heard the name of a great saint from India, Ramesh Bhai Ojha. You must have heard his name. He's a great man. And we are very good friends. Every year for 3 days we are together on a Sangeet Sabha in Varanasi. Before Shivratri, 3 days we are together. So once he asked me, he said, Swamiji, you are always having new things, new gadgets. Do you have iPhone? I said, no, I don't like iPhone. He said, why? Everybody likes iPhone. I said, I don't like iPhone. Well, what is the reason? I said, I don't like iPhone because I don't want I. Then I am a devotee of Bhagavan Krishna. Therefore, Shama Sangha. Like the Gujaratis cannot say sh, they say sir. So actually, originally it is Sham Sangha, but Gujarati Gujju will say Sam Sangha. We have to drop this I. And when this I is dropped, then only the Lord starts expressing through us. See, friends. And how do we know now we have dropped our I? Be attentive. Wherever we are placed, in whatever situation we are placed, whatever may be the time, that place, that situation is ideal for our spiritual evolution. That is the rule. We have no choice. Wherever we are kept, that is the right place. Whatever is the situation, that is the right situation. See? Then, whatever you are supposed to do, do it. No, but I don't like it. Who asked you? Think, friends. Arjuna was kept in a particular situation for a particular job. And it was the divine plan, not Arjuna's plan. But Arjuna has got that arrogance. How can I kill my guru and all that? The guru doesn't know. The grandfather doesn't know. You are the only wise man. Think. And therefore, what is the problem for all of us is this. See, friends. When the whole Bhagavad Gita was heard by Dhritarashtra, nothing happened to him. What happened to Sanjay? Sanjay himself tells at the end, Tachya Sanskrutya Sanskrutya Rupam Atyat Bhutam Harehe. See, I still remember the divine Vishwa Rupa Darshan, and I am so thrilled. Now also I can really feel so good about it. Rishami Mumurvam. And nothing happened to Dhritarashtra. This happened to Sanjay. What happened to Arjun? Ultimately what Bhagavan said? Bhagavan didn't say, did you finish your meditation? He didn't say that. He didn't say, have you chanted the Lord's name? Yajnanam japa yajnasmi. I have done the japa. No. He said, Kaschit ajnana sammohaha pranastaste dharanjaya. Hey Arjun, the delusion that you had as to whether I should fight the war or not fight the war, that delusion is gone or not. And what is Arjuna's answer? Nashto moha smriti labdha. O Lord, now I realize, wherever I am placed, in whatever situation, for whatever job, that is ideal for my evolution. Look in the nature. Which plant can grow where? Who decides? The plant decides or the nature decides? Exactly the same way. Which is the right situation for our spiritual evolution? We don't decide it. See, my friends. And therefore, Bhagavan asks him, has your delusion gone or not? You don't decide what I have to do. We are always placed in the right place. See? Once there was a meeting of all the Mahatmas and God. So, when the Lord came, we all got up, clapped, and the Lord shouted, don't clap, this is not the Indian politics, sit down. So we sat down. Then the Lord said, for the evolution of every single jiva, the soul, I take the responsibility of providing all that is required with reference to time, space, object and situation. So we again clap, again we were scolded, don't do that, okay. Then, what will you do? The Lord asks us. So we say, we'll have a meeting. See, we'll make a committee. You know what is a committee? Those who are not committed to anything individually and collectively they say, you cannot be committed to anything. Such a group of people is called as committee. Come and eat, that's it. Nothing else. So we said, we'll make a committee and then we'll discuss. And let you know. Next day we went to the Lord. Yes, what you have discussed? Then we said, sir, you may provide the right kind of atmosphere, place, situation, time for the evolution of every jiva. It is something like providing the best hardware. What about the software? Then we said, Lord, we will provide the softwares to all these jivas. And the software is satsang. Without the software, hardware is non-functional. All the things are given to us. But how to interact in a given situation? Who teaches us in satsanga? So what is the moral of the story? Every day in our life, there cannot be an excuse when you miss a satsanga. See, today's world, we are fortunate enough. We get on YouTube thousands and thousands of satsanga. Make it a rule. Every day, at least 1 hour, 1.5 hour, you can put your buds in your ears, go for a walk, listen to something great. And slowly, slowly, wrong notions will be erased. Arjuna's wrong notion was, how can I kill my grandfather? His wrong notion was, there will be lot of bloodshed in the battlefield. Then the battlefield, you don't expect. There will be a milkshake. It will be bloodshed. See, friends. And these wrong notions are removed when you listen to satsanga. And the most important thing, new notions are not created. See, friends. And when this will start happening, slowly we will come to the same state where Arjuna came. Nashto mohaha. All wrong notions are gone. Wrong notions about doership. Wrong notions about upasana. Wrong notions about the yoga. Wrong notion about the knowledge. Gone. Therefore, nashto moha, smritihi labdha. Now I remember what for I am in this world. We are in this world only for one purpose. To know the self. Everything else is secondary. If this does not happen, kurute ganga sagar gamanam vrata paripalanam athava danam jnana vihina sarvamatena bhajatina muktim janmashatena Bhaja Govindam, Bhaja Govindam. Keep on the same old tobacco and the chuna, ragadte jao, khate jao. It's not going to help. See, friends, therefore, nashto moha smriti labdha. We have to remember that we are in this world only for one purpose, that is spiritual evolution. The freedom of spiritual evolution is only for human beings, not for the stones, not for the plants, not for the animals. See, at the human level, we have attained perfect evolution at the body level, at the mind level, at the intellect level. So many thousands of years have gone. Monkeys live only on the trees and in the caves. They have not constructed the houses. Cows eat only grass. They don't eat the puffins. Think. Evolution-wise, we have attained perfection. Now the next step in evolution is spiritual evolution. If that is not done, then our condition after listening Bhagavad Gita is what? Unlike Arjuna, Arjuna said, Nashto moha smriti labdha. Our condition is Nashta smriti moha labdha. I have forgotten why I have come over here. Moha labdha. I think everybody is bad. I should be also compete with them. See, friends. Therefore, the moral of the story is, whatever we are doing, we must come back home. We come back home when we sleep. But when we come back home without going to sleep, that is called as living in God. Yanisha sarva bhutanam tasyam jagrati sayami yasyam jagrati bhutani sa nisha pashyatu munehe. This, our essential nature, has to be discovered. That is the only purpose of our life. So what is the moral of the story? Whatever you do, come back home and be happy. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnaat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha Hari Om.